Hi, my name is Jesus Ramirez. This video is part of a series of exercises on Project 1324 to help you build your creative skills. In this tutorial, you're going to learn how to remove distracting elements from your photos using three powerful techniques that anyone can do. If you would like to follow along, you can download the practice files for this tutorial on the page for this video on project1324.com. by Adobe. In this first example, I'm going to show you how to remove this photo bomber in the back. We're going to use a powerful feature in Photoshop that will do most of the work for you. Start by duplicating the photo that you're working with to work non-destructively, just in case you need to come back to the original. With the original layer selected, press Ctrl J, that's Command J on the Mac to duplicate it. Then, from the tools bar, select the lasso tool, which allows you to freehand the selection. Click and drag around the photo bomber to select them. You don't have to be very precise, but try to keep as much of the original background as possible. If you need to subtract from the selection, hold Alt, Option on the Mac, then click and drag around the area that you would like to subtract from. If you hold Shift, as you click and drag, you will add to the selection. With the selection active, you can go into Edit, Fill. From the Contents dropdown, select Content Aware and make sure that Color Adaptation is checked and press OK. And almost like magic, Photoshop removes the photo bomber. To deselect, press Ctrl D, Command D on the Mac, and that removes the marching ants. Marching ants is simply another name for the outline of an active selection. By using Content Aware, Photoshop was able to guess what will be behind this person and seamlessly filled in the background for us. Content Aware works by analyzing pixels surrounding a selection, and it uses that information to generate new pixels. Keep in mind that although very powerful, Content Aware Fill has its limitations and it works best with simple backgrounds. In this next example, I'm going to show you what to do when the Content Aware Fill doesn't complete the job in one step. To remove the person jumping into the pool, you can follow the same process. Press Ctrl J, Command J on the Mac to duplicate the original layer to work non-destructively. Then, with the lasso tool, click and drag around the legs to select them. Try to keep as much of the original background as possible. With the selection active, you can bring up the Fill dialog box by holding Shift and pressing Backspace. That's Shift Delete on the Mac. Photoshop remembers your last settings. Content Aware and Color Adaptation are selected, so just press OK. Notice that in this case, Photoshop had a little more trouble removing the person in the background. The water looks okay, but the side of the pool does not. You can try two things to fix it. First, you can try to make another selection with the lasso tool and try to fill it again with Content Aware. If that doesn't work, you will need to manually paint out those distractions by using the Clone Stamp tool. The Clone Stamp tool allows you to select a source area and paint it into another. It's a lot like copying and pasting, but instead of pasting pixels, you paint pixels with a brush. Hold Alt, Option on the Mac, and click to set your sample source. Notice the brush tip preview. It shows you what you sampled and how it would look against your photo. You can then align your brush tip to your photo and start painting the unwanted areas away. Sometimes you may need to sample from several areas as you paint. In this final example, I'm going to show you how to use a tool that is sort of like Content Aware Fill and the Clone Stamp tool in one. In this image, we have a few people standing in the background that I would like to remove. Press Ctrl J, Command J on the Mac to duplicate the original layer to work non-destructively. Start by selecting the Patch tool, which is nested under the Spot Healing Brush tool in the Tools bar. Then, from the Options bar, select Content Aware. Now you can draw a selection around the person in the back. You can make a loose selection, but try to keep as much of the original background as possible. With Content Aware Fill, Photoshop determines where to sample from. But with the Patch tool, you can tell Photoshop where to sample from. So click and drag the selection to the area that you would like Photoshop to sample from. Make sure that the preview matches the selected area and then release the mouse button. And again, like magic, Photoshop removes the person from the background. You can do the same thing with the people training in the back, make a selection, and click and drag it to an area to sample from. You can even try to remove the soccer player from the image, make a selection around him, try to keep as much of the original background as possible, and drag the selection over to the side to sample from this area. The results are not as good because this area contains a lot of details and it's more complicated. So press Ctrl-D, Command-D on the Mac to deselect. It's best to work on the problem areas individually, select them with the patch tool, and try again. If you're getting blurry edges like I am here, then switch over to the normal patch tool and make sure that source is selected. Content Aware tries to blend nearby pixels and it sometimes creates blurry edges. Notice that in these blurry areas, the normal patch tool does a much better job. Remember that these tools are very powerful, but not perfect. You will have to spend some time fine-tuning your image and trying different tools and techniques to see which gives you the best results. I've just shown you three powerful Photoshop techniques that you can easily master. Give it a try with your own images and share your results on project1324.com. Also, don't forget to check out the other videos in this series to help you build your creative skills. My name is Jesus Ramirez. Thank you so much for watching.